I would like to introduce to you our low power microwave plasma source. This product comes in two flavors, 1 kW fixed power microwave plasma source and 1.5 kW variable power microwave plasma source. This product comes with several parts. The power supply, which converts AC power from the grid into the high voltage power which is required to run this magnetron. The gas box, which precisely controls the plasma gases which are required for the process. The control module that connects to your computer and runs through the software on your computer. And of course, the microwave plasma source itself. So how does this work? The microwave energy, which is produced by the magnetron over here, is funneled down the waveguide into this resonant cavity, which contains one of these. This is a Cerawave ring made out of special type of ceramic with extremely low losses. So having the microwave energy come down this way into the very ring, that microwave energy is then converted into the plasma inside of the gas which passes down this tube in the very center. The field inside is so intense that the gas becomes ionized. What does it mean? That means the electrons are stripped off their atoms and they become ionized. They start emitting lights. So the closest example of plasma is our sun, right? The surface of the sun is about 6,000 degrees Kelvin, and that is the exact same temperature that we have observed within this device. So what are some of the applications of this technology? Well, we have a product in spectroscopy called MICAP OES 1000. At its heart, that product uses one of these plasma sources in order to create plasma, atomize the sample, determine the type of metal and the concentration that is present within the sample. Another example is gasification. Gasification takes the solid waste, such as tires and plastics, and converts them into syngas, as in synthetic gas. But there are others, such as hydrogen reforming or nitrogen fixation. So before we go on to the demo, it is worth mentioning that we have two other products, 10 kW and 100 kW plasma sources. We will talk about those in our next video. It is now time for the demo. Here we have a typical setup. The power supply, gas box with mass flow controllers, the control box which controls the whole thing, and our plasma source. To my right, we have a Windows PC which runs our software, and to my left, we have the exhaust system which pulls all the plasma gases out into the open. What's going to happen next? I'm going to press the auto ignition button in the software, and the system is then going to go through a 15 seconds auto ignition sequence to ignite plasma. While the system is igniting, it is important to note that this is air plasma. The plasma gas is air, but the system can equally run on CO2 or nitrogen. And there it is. The system is currently running at full power, 1.5 kilowatts, and 15 liters of plasma gas. In this case, like I said, air. I can now change the power level to say 1000 watts. And as you can see, the plasma has gotten smaller because less microwave energy is being converted into plasma. Going back to full power. I can also change the plasma gas flow rate from 15 to say 20. The plasma has gotten smaller because more gas is passing through, and therefore the average temperature on the output is a little less. I can now go to lower flow rate to, for example, 13 liters per minute. The plasma is now longer because the average temperature of plasma on the output is higher and the plasma elongates. I can also go down to 12 liters per minute and the plasma is even bigger. And there it is. This is our low power microwave plasma source. And this brings us to the end of the video. As you have seen, this was a 1.5 kilowatt microwave plasma source, which produced plasma out of air. This system can also run on CO2 or nitrogen. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and follow us on X or LinkedIn. Thank you very much for your time, and we'll see you in the next one.